Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick, your brother from another mother, coming to you live via satellite from the United States. God bless you guys. Hope you're doing all right. Been extremely busy. Been wanting to make lots of videos and things that the Lord has shown me. And the Lord has been giving me several dreams, brothers and sisters, all about this other vision that I had, the one that seems to be such a pivotal thing that the Lord showed me about the rapture and all that. And the Lord just keeps showing me more and more, brothers and sisters, and I do believe it's all connected to the blood moons and all those things that I would not say if the Lord hadn't led me, you know, led me in that area. Anyway, brothers and sisters, I came on here to make a video to ask you guys to pray about that the Lord would release me to talk about the things that the Lord showed me about this 4 and 4:4 and 4:4:4, all interconnected and all pointing to the beginning of the tribulation, the rapture, and all those things. I ask you guys to pray that the Lord would give me further understanding and revelation about it. And I was just looking and see that I got me a sports jacket, praise the Lord, at a very, very, very discount price. I only paid about 20% of the price of this jacket. So praise God for what an awesome blessing it was to be able to get this jacket at 80% off. So praise the living God. Brothers and sisters, also ask for your prayers. I believe that I'm planning on going to the Seattle area as one area, but I was praying and asking the Lord about going to Seattle in July, and I believe the Lord has spoke to me about going up toward, you know, the north, Midwest, up to like the Chicago to the Minneapolis area. Now, after the Lord spoke to me and, you know, was showing me that area, there was, you know, a brother who was talking to me about being baptized up there in the Minneapolis area. And so, you know, that was the next day after the Lord had talked to me about that same area. So praise God, brothers and sisters. I ask for your prayers about that. I ask for your feedback. Those are in the Chicago area. If you could meet me in Minneapolis, or the Minneapolis people could meet me in Chicago or somewhere in that area, that's a good place to go into. I don't know. You know, I'm praying about it. And I ask you guys to pray in agreement with me about that. You know, maybe I could fly into both, you know, and hopscotch there and have the ticket price nearly the same. Who knows? I have to start exploring that. So I ask you guys to pray about that, because there's several people that want to be baptized, and that's what, you know, I'm going to do. I'm going to baptize at least about 3 different people, at least, that's talked to me about it, and maybe there's a whole lot more. So if you're in the Minneapolis area, the Chicago, greater Chicago area, in between, and you can drive to those areas, please let me know. There's lots of sisters and brothers. One sister I'm thinking of down in Illinois. I think she's more in the southern Illinois area. Let me know about that, brothers and sisters. Anyway, brothers and sisters, you know there's lots of things going on. And as the Lord had led me, if you remember, maybe a month ago, to pray for Alex Jones. And, you know, some people, no matter what name you mention, there's people that hate Billy Graham. There's people that hate anybody you mention. And, you know, I thank the Lord. Brother Alex Jones has been promoting more and more the gospel, getting more and more serious about the gospel. And I haven't heard him in the last few days, but I'm going to bet that this shooting that happened in the church in Charleston was what they call a false flag. You know, I saw the picture of the young guy who did it. I heard his best friend is the one who turned, you know, gave his name to the police. And the mom of his best friend said, oh, he comes to my house and plays Xbox all the time. So here's some young punk grown up in the modern era. Has no idea or anything about all of these racism things and all that. Never lived, you know, anyone who was born, you know, since the 19, even my age, unless people were old enough to know anything in the 1960s, you know, they lived in a pre-segregated, you know, in a post-segregated South. And I will just say this, that the government's plan, and I usually don't talk politics, brothers and sisters, but those of you who watch my videos and are in the loop of what's going on in the world and are informed, we know that the man's plan is on the back of the American dollar bill. it says, you know, announcing a new order for the ages, or a new world order. The first half of that sentence is out of chaos, a new world order. So the man's plan, the Illuminati, the devil, Lucifer, these wicked people that rule the world in high places, and their gods with a small g, these fallen angels and stuff, principalities and all that, they want to bring chaos to the world. So they use everything. As the devil comes to kill, steal, and destroy, as Jesus said in John chapter 10, but Jesus has come to give us life. You know, I usually don't go negative, but I'm just discussing this. Now, Satan's plan for the ages, which reminds me, as soon as you get those people that ask for a book, as soon as you get your book, please email me that you got your book. Let me know. But I'm just thinking about it. So Satan's plan for the ages, brothers and sisters, is to bring disorder so that they can bring in this new world order, this fascist dictatorship. So you've got, like what Hitler tried to do. So you've got Ebola, you've got the bird flu, swine flu, you've got the European Union, you know, currency maybe about to collapse with Greece, you know, the dollar, the American debt. You've got the military-industrial complex, you know, trying to start a war with Russia and through the Ukraine and all of the Middle Eastern countries destabilized and in collapse. And then you've got the HAARP. You've got these, you know, volcanoes going off all over the place, earthquakes either caused by HAARP or natural, and both radical weather changes here. You know, it's been way up in the 90s, pushing 100 degrees, mid-90s to 100, even on and on and on, which normally, you know, even here, even though I'm in North Carolina, we still only have, you know, say 10 days a year in the 90s or whatever, in like the what they call the dog days, which relates to the dog star, the Sirius, which is actually the star that people, that the Egyptians worshipped, was the dog star. That's why we use the expression dog days, like the movie Dog Day Afternoon, which is a satanic movie anyway. That dog star, those hottest days is the time that we would see above 90s, you know, consistently, even this far south. But now we've had on and on and on 90 degrees for days on end. It's out of character. We've had this extreme cold in Dallas. I talked to a brother, Darren, down there in Dallas, and he was saying that it was, you know, over 100 degrees in the shade, and they had a real cold winter there too. So we know, you know, there's people that will say this is done by the HAARP and by the government, and then it's also, you know, it's, you know, signs from the Lord that the end is near. So both, you know, the government is trying to manipulate the weather with the chemtrails and all that stuff. That's all true. But of course, the Lord is sending, you know, the signal to all people everywhere that the end is at hand. I mean, this is, you know, we're in the season of the rapture of the church, the true bride of Christ, and then it's time for the tribulation period to begin. We are in that window. We're in that season. Now, could it be, you know, was it a week, a month, a year, 2 years, 3 years? You know, Lord knows. But, the vast majority of people who can hear from the Lord, you know, everyone is seeing that with the signs and the sun, moon, and stars and the blood moons and all that, that it's a huge signs from God that, you know, this is a huge season right now this year. So praise God, brothers and sisters, for people who are born again or who will get right with God before the rapture happens. It is good news. And you know, brothers and sisters, 99% of my videos, I try to, you know, the Lord, I will say, I don't try. The Lord gives me the anointing to be an exhorter, you know, to exhort. And then very rarely will I be, you know, hit on that the negative side. Not that I don't talk about sin. I'm talking about the hopelessness of part one of the gospel. It's, you know, I'm just thinking about it. Hey, that's pretty cool. Thank you, Lord. See how the Lord is? You know, like the New World Order, you know, the devil copies everything God does. The devil's thing is, it's actually from what they call the Cume Sibyl. It's one of the oracles of Apollo, Apollyon, the destroyer, who is really the fallen angel principality who will possess the Antichrist, we see in Revelation. The captain of the bottomless pit, Apollyon, or Abaddon in Hebrew, the destroyer. Apollo, he said through one of his little witches, like the Oracle of Delphi, that's the most famous one. Paul cast the Python spirit, it says in the NIV and all that. That's the same, same spirit, Apollyon. The Python spirit, you know, a snake. So The motto of the devil for the New World Order is out of chaos, a new world order. So out of chaos, the false good news. The bad news is out of chaos, and the good news is a new, to them, the false good news is a new world order where everything's in order, from chaos to order, but an evil order. Take the mark, I will chop your head off. You know, fall in line, you know, fascism like what Hitler did, like what the, you know, Hirohito, whatever, the Japanese imperialism, like the fascism that we're experiencing in America today, or, you know, Mao Zedong, which is more than the U.S. so far, Stalin, you know, all of these dictators who had this fascism dictatorship and what we're going to with the New World Order. You know, so you can look at Stalin and Hitler, particularly Hitler, because he marked the Jews, tried to kill the Jews, you know, with a mark, with computer marking and all these things. You can see these are type of shadows of that New World Order, which is awesome if you're Satanist, a Luciferian, New World Order, survival of the fittest, and let's kill all the weak people and kill all the religious people and all this. But it's not good news for Christians. So, but God also, you know, Satan was copying with God's gospel. So the devil's gospel, false gospel, is out of all the chaos of freedom and liberty and freedom of choice. You know, God gives us, unlike what the Middle Ages with the Inquisition, God doesn't kill us instantly if we don't follow Jesus. We have a free will. And then when we die, we're judged. That's when it comes in where you're going to go. But while you're on this earth, we have a free will to choose. With the devil, there is no free choice. He's going to chop off your head if you don't take the mark. Now, the good news of God is, the Bible says, all have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. Or let me use another Bible verse that's even better. The wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ. Thank you, Lord. And I believe that's what I'm going to tell in this video. You know, Satan has a pattern of the gospel, a false gospel. Out of chaos, chaos to the devil, you know, God, the devil calls good evil and evil good. Chaos is freedom, liberty, you know, Christianity, and whatever religion, even if people want to be a Buddhist, Hindu, whatever, they have a right and a free will to choose that and then reject the gospel. That's all of that is chaos to the devil if everyone is not on drugs, under his control, on Prozac, and like that boy that did the shooting in Charleston, you know, he's, you can look at his picture, the guy that did the shooting in Denver, you know, they're all zoned out on drugs, psychotropic drugs, as they call them, from the man. The side effects of all those drugs is, you know, suicide and rage and all these things. This is all part of the devil's plan, brothers and sisters, to get everybody on these drugs. You know, they don't, you know, Obama's already just come out and said, of course, it's the guns. Yeah. You know, if so, someone is drunk and driving a car and runs over somebody, we need to ban cars because cars are deadly. You know, I mean, it's the same concept. No, the guy who got drunk and drove the car is the deadly one, not the weapon he chose to use. There are people that take a knife and like Lizzie Borden, you know, whatever that poem is, you know, Lizzie Borden took a knife and whatever, she gave her mom a 40 wax, and when she seen what she had done, she gave whatever, you know. That, you know, she used an axe. She could, they had guns at that time. She could have used a gun. She didn't. She used an axe. We're going to ban axes, you know. But I don't want to get into the politics of it, brothers and sisters. Just the deception, because what the devil's trying to do, and the devil's biggest obstacle, is Christian America. And under Christian America, it's not about Christians having guns. You know, I have atheists. Relatives who will say, oh, Christians shouldn't have guns. Yeah, the devil's people would always say that, you know, to try to undermine. It's not a matter of Christians having guns or not having guns. It's that in our system of government, that Judeo-Christian culture that created America, you know, the Magna Carta in England, you know, all those things God aligned up. You know, that the Magna Carta would give way to the King James Bible and all those things came together, the printing press, the Gutenberg printing press, as I wrote about in the book. Again, in the fullness of times, God made a way that the Enlightenment really came, the Enlightenment not of the Illuminati, but the Enlightenment of the gospel coming out of England with the Magna Carta and the King James Bible and the printing press and all those things made way for the greatest period in church history since the time of the apostles. Since the Dark Ages began, really, when they consolidated Christianity and put it under the papacy, the explosion of the truth of the Bible being written in everybody's languages and all that. We've just coming out of that period, brothers and sisters, and the American Constitution and all that was a product of the Christianity and Judeo-Christian ideas, you know, of all the things they did, of the judges and all that. They, if you go read the Founding Fathers' documents, you'll see that they based the Constitution and all that off the Old Testament, the Law of Moses, about, you know, judging and the penalties, first-degree murder and all that stuff, and based off of, you know, from the legal system from England and out of the Magna Carta with a trial by jury. That's the greatest thing about the Magna Carta, trial by jury, not by, you know, a kangaroo court and all that, but a jury of your peers and all those things. And so, brothers and sisters, we're at the end of that age. We're at the end of that time. And so the news from the Lord for the lost is bad news unless they repent. So for us, for people that repent, the people that are born again, the people that are saved, that belong to the Lord Jesus Christ, you know, we heard the bad news that the wages of sin is death. And then the good news, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ. That's the real gospel, the real good news. And so the devil's people, all of these wicked people that have rejected the gospel, it's bad news. They don't want to hear about that sodomy and being a transgender and all these things, and that Baphomet spirit, all of these things is going to be judged by God. So they're rejecting the truth of God and rejecting the real deal that the Lord is the judge, that God is going to judge the Lord Jesus Christ. As it says in King James, he's coming back to judge the quick and the dead, the living and the dead. That's bad news to the devil's people. And that's good news for us, brothers and sisters. It's good news because it says that, you know, we pass from death to life, you know, and that we're not going to be judged because we're in Christ with the righteousness of Christ. Now, there's the judgment seat of Christ for our rewards. I'm not talking about that. Losing your rewards. I'm talking about the judgment of hell or heaven. When you're born again and truly born again, truly converted and given your heart to the Lord Jesus Christ, and you've been born again, brothers and sisters, the Bible says that in Colossians, we've been translated from the kingdom of darkness to the kingdom of his dear son, the Bible says. Paul said, we've been translated to the kingdom of his dear son. That's our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. You've been translated. Just like the same word used for the rapture will be translated. So we've been spiritually translated now when we're born again. We're spiritually moved by God from the kingdom of darkness to the kingdom of light, to the kingdom of his dear son, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. All those people in the kingdom of darkness, they have that false gospel that they think is good news, that out of the chaos of freedom and liberty and the Constitution and the right to bear arms and all those things to defend the right to bear arms, in the natural world, brothers and sisters, dealing with evil people, because there is real evil in this world. And God uses the police, the Bible tells us, and all those things. God uses authorities, Romans 13. He uses the military and all that to bring justice sometimes. He even used evil people to bring his justice, just like he's going to use the Antichrist. God used Nebuchadnezzar to bring his judgment on the tribe of Judah there and take them into captivity into Babylon. God used that Sennacherib, the Assyrian king, to take the northern kingdoms into captivity before 750 BC, approximately. So, brothers and sisters, God will use the Antichrist to bring judgment, the controlled opposition to bring judgment on people that have rejected the gospel. And they want to believe the false gospel, that there's a new world order, a new order for the ages, a new age, what they call the new age. That's the same thing. What's really the old age, the same old lie. And guess what that lie is? And I've said this all the time, maybe some of you haven't heard me. You know what the bottom line, the lie, which is the oldest lie in the Bible, and they call it the New Age. And guess what it is? It's just so simple, brothers and sisters, when I tell you. It's laughable. This is what Satan told Eve in the garden. When you eat that fruit, God doesn't want you to eat the fruit because he knows when you eat it, you'll become like him. That is the good news to the devil's people. I am. You know, they proclaim, I am. Like Shirley MacLaine, out on a limb, she proclaimed, I am. I am a God. I am a God. My higher self, my God consciousness, the Christ consciousness. They use all these terms. They are calling themselves a God. And that's what taking the mark will do for you. You will think you'll become a God. What happens is your DNA will be changed. You will become a Gibor, a Nephilim. You will become a Superman. For that period of time, my friends, that period of time, that short season of 7 years that the devil and his people will rule and reign. But what about the next day? What about the day after tomorrow, like that movie, that environmental propaganda movie? What about the day after tomorrow? What about eternity? What about eternity waking up in hell and never having peace, never knowing love, totally alone and abandoned and in torment for eternity? It's not worth it. It is not worth it. Do not receive the false good news of a new world order and a new age, but receive the good news, the real good news, the truth. Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. A lot of people, you know, use that Bible verse that Jesus said, John 14:6, and say, you know, that, you know, Jesus is the only way to heaven. But listen to what he says. I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except by me, but truth. He is truth. As Jesus said in John 17, when he talked to the Father, when Jesus, that's the real Lord's Prayer. What we call the Lord's Prayer is really the Apostles' Prayer. The Apostle said, the disciples said, how should we pray? Teach us to pray. And then Jesus told them, our Father who art in heaven. But the Lord's Prayer is at the Last Supper in John 17. The Lord prayed to the Father, you know, and said, let them be one as we are one, and all those things that he said. And he told the Father, he said, thy word is truth. In the beginning was the Word was with God, and the Word was God. And then the Word became flesh and dwelt among us. John chapter 1, Jesus Christ is the Word made flesh. That's why he is the way, the truth, and the life. So the truth is, all have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. There's none righteous, no, not one, that all tongues would be stopped and be silent before God. For the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ. My dear friend, if you're watching this video, there is only one good news, one true good news, and that is through the blood of Jesus Christ. In Hebrew, they say Yeshua. Lots of people on YouTube keep using that. It doesn't matter what language you speak, Jesus, Cristo in Spanish or Filipino, Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, the one and only Son of God, of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob, the God of Israel. He is our God. Today is the day of salvation. Today is the day for you to put your trust in the Lord. Don't put your trust in all the deception in this world. I started in this video talking about the deception of the devil. The devil is trying to start a race war in the United States. This young punk is some kind of a Manchurian candidate. He's some kind of a Prozac out video game playing punk. He doesn't know racism in any way, for any shape or form. I'm sure he's as a matter of fact, I saw a thing where, you know, a lot of his friends, of course, he's a regular, went to high school, and all the schools have been desegregated for two generations now. You know, those things don't exist. You know, the people live, even though people have different cultures, in the South, people live peacefully. The place where violence is usually your big cities, and L.A., Chicago, Baltimore, all these places is where you have more segregation than we ever do down here anymore since the 1960s. Just want to say that. People that's not from this area. People have been living harmonious down here in the South because people have learned to accept each other. Hey, people have different cultural things. You know, but for even young people now, they don't even have that anymore. Now people have cultural, you know, the cultural differences are going away. You know, now that we're in the second generation of since desegregation in, like, say, the 1960s, end of the 1960s. So all those things with people that age, they don't even know anything like that. People my age, we only heard about it. And then people this young generation, they don't even know about those things. It's not even, you know, I'm telling you, it's not even part of their life. Unless you're some kind of a, you know, you're raised in some kind of a, you know, these people that go on Oprah Winfrey and Jerry Springer and all that, these old, what we call trailer park white trash people, you know, who are act worse than anybody in the whole world, love to talk about everybody else. That's all people. But anyway, brothers and sisters, I'm talking more natural stuff than I normally do. But praise God, brothers and sisters, through whom all blessings flow. We have the victory through our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And I have lots of spiritual things to talk to you guys about. By the grace of God, I'll be back later on. And God bless you all, and ask for your prayers and feedback about going to do the baptisms and visitations and praying for people, for healings and all this kind of stuff, giving people words of wisdom, words of knowledge up there in that area, meeting in person. God bless you guys. Please get back to me. And please, those of you who ordered the books or the prayer oil, please let me know that you got it. Okay, God bless.